do research on multimodal communication, we actually annotate manually or automatically, if it is possible, both speech. So speech is transcribed and gestures are annotated, facial expressions are annotated, manually or automatically identified and then corrected. And this is done in existing tools where speech is put on a timestamp, and you can divide the speech in phonemes or words or contribution, depending on the type of research you want to do. And then gestures are annotated, or functions are annotated in lines, like in music, and they are time aligned with speech. So both qualitative and quantitative data are analyzed on these annotations. And of course, when you annotate, you look at the videos and can address certain aspects. But we do qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis as in computational linguistics by extracting the annotations and making statistics on them, and applying machine learning on it, and so on. So the methodology is the same used in for text and dialogues and so on. We just add the gestures, annotations to it. The finding of our Parla-Klar in a paper about the difference, gender difference in the parliamentary debates, Danish parliamentary debates, and the topic addressed by the politicians was that actually there are great differences in the topics that females are experts in committees or when they speak, of course. And it wasn't surprising because it is common in many countries. So what surprised us, there was the difference was the same in Denmark as in countries that you wouldn't think are so advanced in equality between women and men. And the other thing that surprised us was that women spoke much longer in the parliament in the period where we had a prime minister that was female, that in the period where there were male, even if there were more ministers and were ministers under the male prime minister than the female prime minister. So there are a lot of factors that may influence how female and male are seen in the political scene. I use the Klarin infrastructure to work with parliamentary data. I have contributed to the infrastructure by giving annotations of a multimodal communication. And I use the infrastructure in teaching. So some of my students, especially those working on Danish data, they use data from the Klarin infrastructure to do research. And I also look at what is found in the European Klarin in order to find whether there are tools that are interesting for me. We have also a part of speech tagging. Many of the tools that have been developed at CSD are very, or by other researchers that are in the infrastructure, are easier to use in the Klarin infrastructure than in other ways.